Hey everyone, how's it going everybody? Hope you're keeping well and having a fantastic day or weekend whenever you are watching this review video. This is the very first N-scale model train review to come of November 2022, and no, we're not reviewing the Class 92, folks. I've just used that there to support this model. This is the one we're going to be reviewing, and this is the second Graham Farish Bachmann N-scale Class 60. And this one, my friends, is 6100, and I'm just going to support that from the bottom so it doesn't slide out. The reference number is 371-359, Class 60, as 6100, named as Midland Railway-Butterley, in the DB cargo livery. And this is a brand new 2022 release, and this has the Next18 DCC connectivity. So this uses the latest generation of DCC decoders. At least it was the case at the time this video is being made. So that may change in the future, who knows. And without further ado, let's slide out the model from the box and let's see what we are presented with. Okay, just like with 6096, we are presented with the locomotive in the newer style blister packaging. And I've got to be honest, I do like this blister packaging a lot better than the old foam one, because you can see the model better and there is a array of detailed parts that are included, of which is for two valances. And here are the instructions. What I'm going to do first, before we unbox this, let's go through the paperwork and that first. As with the Class 92 review, I nearly forgot to do the instructions, and it just occurred to me when I moved on to the rotation. So I'll try to avoid making those mistakes, and I do improve, or at least try and improve on future videos. As you know, I'm still relatively getting back into N-scale, but I do have a load of nice model trains in N-scale to come throughout this year. Well, for the last part of this year anyways. Just like with 6096, we've got the warranty. So if something goes wrong, you can send it back to Bachmann and they will fix it free of charge. And there's the collector's club and all that good stuff as well. So that's the first one down. This is your instructions. So I'm just going to go through these briefly, as we did cover them quite in depth with 6096, and I try to avoid being too repetitive with my reviews, you know, as I like to keep them interesting. But usual culprits, that's a coreless motor, Next18 DCC connectivity, speaker installed, all-wheel pickup, although sadly no working marker lights on these models. But I suppose if you're very good, you could always add your own. And just tells you about lubrication, DCC decoder fitting, and all that good stuff. And there are some switches for the taillights at both ends, with one being at the front, nearest to the fans, and cab number two end, towards the exhaust. Okay, that's all the instructions done. So without further ado, let's jump straight in into the fun part, and that's unboxing this fantastic model from Bachmann Graham Farish. As you know, I believe it was around 2000 when Bachmann took over Graham Farish, and they have improved the models considerably in the recent years. If the Class 47s and these revised Class 6s or anything to go by, so that's all grand. Just sliding this sleeve off, and as you know, I'm very diligent with my models and I do treat them with respect, so I don't rough handle them or anything, so I'm very diligent. But if the camera is picking this up, these are quite securely taped down, a bit in a different position this time around compared to the Class 60 that I covered in the last review. Well, the first one of this year in N-scale, as that was my special treat to myself. And I had to get this one because I do like this 6100, as I did have the Hornby model, but as you know, I no longer cover 00 scale, so I'm now with N-scale model trains, and that will be for the foreseeable future, as N-scale is very nice, compact, and easy to transport. So let's get this one out of the box then, shall we, folks? And here we are. Just going to place that down somewhere safe. And we do have the model. Nice amount of weight. And come to think of it, just as an estimate here, I'd say this is about 80 to 100 grams. And I'd say this is about probably the weight of 2, maybe 2.5 bars of Cadbury's Dairy Milk. So that's just an estimate for you. But honestly, plenty of weight in this model. So don't underestimate its size. It is built for hauling, as these are heavy duty freight locomotives. And we do have the nameplate. I'm not sure if these are etched or not. So actually they're not, they're just printed on, okay. But I would imagine you can get metal nameplates if you want to enhance it, but I'm happy for this as OEM spec. It does the job, and I really do like this DB livery. And we've got the DB large logo there too. And 6100, but we'll cover more of this in the close-ups. And of course, the full rotation. Very nice detail all around. Just want to show you the roof, as I did forget to do that with the review of 6096. And on the underside, we do have these all-wheel drive, and there is no traction tires on any of the wheels. Just making sure I've got this in camera view for you folks, okay? And just making sure we've got everything covered. Although from what I've read on some of the forums, these axle hoses can ground themselves on some of the cutto points. Apparently it's where the plastic rail guards are. So what I might have to do, when I do build my full-scale model railway, and if I have to use those kind of switches, I will probably grind off about 1 to 2 millimeters of plastic, just so that these trains can run, as they are fantastic models, and I'm not prepared to go without my Class 60s over a flaw in the track design on the cutto points. So I will modify those if I can, or if not, I'll just restrict these to the main lines only. So anyways, I think we've now covered the introduction, so I just want to place that fantastic model. In fact, just bear with me. I'm going to move that tree, and I'll just flip that upside down. So we've got some nice solid ground for our Class 60. And if I'm not mistaken, I think we've now covered the introduction. So I just wanted to show you what you get with these Class 60s. Although I did a more thorough cover of this model on 6096, so it's the coreless rail freight version. So if you stumbled across this video first and you want a more in-depth coverage, please do check out my other N-scale model train reviews, okay? And that is the introduction all done. So the next thing for us to do, as we have covered the instructions and the unboxing and all that, is to move on to close-ups, rotation, and of course, the performance test. Okay, I will be back very soon. It's now time for the close-ups, and without further ado, let's release the tripod and let's home in on the leading cab, as this is cab number one. Just going to turn my screen slightly upwards so I can see what I'm doing, as there's too much reflection there from the light in this room. And we do have flush glazing all round. Not sure if they're separately fitted window wipers or not, but we do have separately fitted lamp irons, handrails, grab irons and all that good stuff. Very nice model. I do really like this one. I may even paint these buffers grey, just like I did with my Hornby model. So that will come later. So I'll just use some Tamiya masking tape just to protect the front when I do that. And all metal handrails here, see-through grills to slot with 6096. Very nice livery, crisp application. As I was saying there, I just didn't want to sneeze on the video, so I had to cut that in half, as I do suffer from winter hay fever, so apologies for that. But anyway, very nice crisp livery application. I don't know how close we can go before the camera decides to go crazy on me, but I'm going to keep going no matter what. We do have decos from the, well, for the overhead catenary system. We've got the cantrail warning stripes on the grey roof, although it's very hard to see them on the red part of the livery. But we do have the Midland Railway bodily name boards there too, although these are just decos, they're not actually etched. And sadly, there is no etch plates included with these models, but I am sure that there could be some third party aftermarket parts available if you wanted to upgrade the model with metal nameplates. But we do have painted footsteps, so that's a very nice touch. The rest of the livery is very nicely applied. Of course, these models are about the same price as about 13 to 15 packets of cigarettes, so just to give you a rough idea on how much these models cost. But they do vary between model train dealers and stockists, so shop about and you will find one for a good deal. Okay, as far as I know, I believe that is all the details done for these close-ups. So the next thing for me to do is to move on to the next part, that will be the rotation, and then we will be doing the performance test. Okay, it will be with the same test train as we did with 6096, but I've got a surprise for you as terms of the background train, and that will be, has never been seen on this channel before, but that will be reviewed possibly around late November or even early December. But that's all I'm going to say, folks, okay? So keep an eye out for that one. So without further ado, moving on to the full rotation. Okay, folks, without further ado, let's zoom out and let's do that clockwise rotation then, shall we? So just taking this back and going clockwise, just like we did with 6096. I'm going to come out a wee bit more, but not too much, as I don't need to zoom out as far as I do with the 00 gauge scale models, as they are much larger. This one is nice and compact, being N scale. And we can just do a nice steady rotation, just letting all the detail very much speak for itself, as it's self-explanatory. Very nice model in my opinion. High quality. And I do like these Farish Class 6s. And just coming on to the offside as we return towards cab number one. And just getting the position right. And therefore, that, my friends, is the full rotation done. And just zooming right in, just to finish off, that, my friends, is the conclusion of the full rotation of this N-Scale Class 60 from Graham Farish Bachmann. And it's now time to have some serious fun. And that will be with the performance test. It's now time for us to have some fun, folks. And without further ado, it's now time to commence on with the performance test. And I do have a sneak preview of what will be coming in my reviews, and you're gonna love this one. I certainly do. But the background train will be very much self-explanatory. But before we launch that one, let's get the Class 60 running first then, folks. As you know, I've reconfigured the feeder track so that forwards is forwards and not in reverse. So let's get some power to the track then, folks, and let's get this Class 6100 moving, and let's see how it performs. And for the benefit of this review, I have left the taillights turned on, although you can always disable these when hauling a train on your model railway. But as I like to do these unofficial reviews, of which are candid, honesty, integrity and morality, as I give this from an unbiased point of view, I like to show you the model in action for itself. And let's start up the background training, folks. You're going to love this one. I certainly do. And the review of that is a Kato Class 800-0, will come either at the end of this month of November, or it will be early December, as I do have some more gems to show you. So I thought I'd give you a sneak preview of what's to come. As you know, I like yous to enjoy my model train content, as well as my Let's Plays. And the Let's Plays will come right through to the end of the year. But as and when and what types of train related Let's Plays they will be, it really all depends on the day when I make them, of what train simulator or transport related game I decide to use. So we're currently on exactly 50% power there, folks. This is a brand new Graham Farish Bachmann Class 60. So as for the Kato Class 800-0, I'm using the Hornby R914 train controller, and this is the lowest speed that I can do with the Kato Class 800. So it is going significantly faster, as the coreless motor on the Class 800 is more responsive and it is higher geared. So, and this old vintage Hornby train controller that I'm using, it doesn't really have slow speed control. It's kind of more or less, once you turn it on, it's a minimum of 3 volts. So there's nothing like 1.5 volts or anything like that. So it's more or less quarter power straight off the bat. That's the fast, well, that's the size of the Class 800 will run with this controller. If I had another Kato controller, I probably would have had more control over the speed, you know. But as you can tell, it's mostly the Class 800 that is making most of the noise, but it's not really the motor. It's just the wheels and the axles where the noise is coming from. But anyways, what I'm going to do here is I will allow about probably 1 to 2 more passes for this one. And what I will do, we will cover the Class 800 in a future review, I promise you. But I just wanted to put something nice and modern in the background, you know. Because for the next review, the Class 60, this one, 6100, is going to be a background train. So this one will step down and become a background train for the next model train that I'm going to review. And yes, it is another Kato model train, but it's not this Class 800. As I'm reviewing these model trains in almost the order that I bought them and not when I received them, so there is a few that is back to front of when they arrived to me. But you know, the reason I started off with 6096 was because that model train is kind of special, as it was a graduation present, of which I covered in that video, so I don't want to repeat too much in all of me reviews. But honestly, I do like this portable layout, although it's not detailed by any means. It's just a nice test track to run some trains and have some fun, and also do these unofficial reviews, because I really love doing these truthful, unbiased reviews, because I want the buyer who may go out there and buy these model trains to know exactly what they're looking for. Anyway, folks, I'm going to allow about probably one more after this pass, and then we will switch the camera just so I can show you the taillights And I have adjusted the microphone in a better position this time around, so hopefully it won't sound so bouncy like I did notice in the previous review. So I'm hoping my voice is not bouncing around this room. Although I don't know why it echoes, because this room is not empty. So why that is the case is beyond anybody's guess. But anyways, switching the camera once both trains are clear from the filming zone. Okay, we now have 6100 just coming into the filming zone, and just like the 60096, the taillights on 6100 are of the correct ambience, as they're not too bright, they're not too dull. This classic is exactly running on 50% power. It is a brand new model, so it probably will need about 30 to 45 minutes, which I recommend a running session, just to allow the drive line and the gearing to bed in. Okay, it's a very nice model, and considering the rail things are limited to 60 miles an hour, as they are a heavy duty freight locomotive, they're not really built for speed. They're more built for power than speed. So 60 miles an hour at the time these were built was more than acceptable. And I would assume that if the real Class 60s were to run at higher speeds, then probably new traction motors that are more powerful would have to be retrofitted to make these locomotives capable and to go faster. But it's not so much of an issue with the locomotives, it's due to the fact that the loads, like the oil trains, they are limited to just 60 miles an hour. So that's the reason for the Class 60s being built to that speed. Although the design speed is 62 miles an hour, that relates to 100 kilometers an hour. So that's the design speed, but the top speed is 60 miles an hour, or 98 kilometers an hour, if I have my calculations correct. As I do measure in miles an hour, so I'm just trying to give you a rough translation from miles to kilometers an hour. Okay, as you know, I really do like to help you if I can. I do like helping people, so when I do feel that I'm helping someone, it feels great, and that's what these reviews are for. Okay, I think one more pass after this one, and then we'll start wrapping up this review. Of course, with our final score and verdict. And I just thought I'd put this Kato Class 800-0 as a background train, just to give you a taster of what's to come in terms of my N-scale model train reviews. And this train is just fabulous quality, I've got to admit that. Absolutely well made, but I'm not here to review that one. That will come in a future video, either at the end of this month or in December. And once this train has cleared the filming zone, it will be time to switch the camera back to its original position, and then we can start winding down this review. Okay, I hope you have enjoyed this one. As you know, sadly, there is just one thing I will knock one point off this model, of which I did mention on the review of the Collis Rail 60096. Personally, when Bachmann and Graham Farish, who is owned by Bachmann, I would have liked to have seen Bachmann implemented working marker lights, as it's only the daylight mode on the headlight, which is just this Y only one light working, as in the UK, on the older, especially the older ex-British rail locomotives, such as the Class 60, it's usually two marker lights and one day, or two marker lights and one night, although it can only be one marker and one day on some locomotives. So this one represents the marker lights that have just been painted on the sides. Sadly, non-functional, hence why I've taken 1 point off. Performance is very good all round, very silent moving, there's no signs of struggle, responsiveness is there, although it is a brand new model, so once it's been run for long enough, it will improve after about 30 to 45 minutes, once it's had a running session in each direction. That will allow the driveline and the gearing to bed in. In all honesty, the price of these models, they can vary considerably. So please folks, shop about, look for the best deal, and make your money go further. That's my advice on this, okay? Okay, features. I'm gonna give that a 4 out of 5, because like I said about the marker lights, the detail, I'm going to give that a full house 5 out of 5, as the livery, the decals, the nameplates, they're all crisp and well applied. No fuzz, no distortion, and they are high quality printing. Price, for mine, full house 5 out of 5. Performance is 5 out of 5, so therefore, that rounds up the final score for this Bachmann Graham Farish Class 60 end scale as DB Cargo 6100 with a 9 out of 10, folks. That's a very good score because it really is a nice model, despite the fact that there is no working marker lights. If you're really good with electronics, I suppose you could do some modifications and add your own, but I may have a go at making the other headlight work just to compensate for the lack of illuminated marker lights. So I'm happy to do that, as some of the refurbished Class 60s with DC rail, they have the new LED headlight clusters. Well, especially 6028 has that in the real world, so I could replicate that with my N-scale Class 60s, as then I could have two headlights, as where it looks better than just painted marker lights, you know. But anyways, I'm going to do research on that, and if you have any advice on how I could do this, please let me know in the comment section below. And for constructive and positive feedback, comments, questions, post what you like, you know, I do read your comments and I do respond to them, as I do listen to positive and constructive feedback, as well as advice and comments on what your thoughts are about these model trains. Please do let me know in the comment section below. Okay, time to start wrapping up. Big thank you for watching. As always, take care of yourselves and each other. All the best, God bless, take care, and I will catch you in another video coming soon to this channel. And if you're not already a subscriber and you've just come across this video, please do hit that subscribe button, as I do have model train videos every Saturday between now and the end of the year. That's a promise. There'll be a mix of model train reviews, which are unofficial, as I give it truthfully, as I'm not sponsored or supported by any model train or any organisation for that matter, as I pay for these trains out of my own pocket. And it's great to be back into N-scale. Anyway, folks, that's all for now. Look after yourselves, and I will see you in another video coming soon, okay?